Hello guys, welcome to the second video. And in this video you are going to see how I make the pocket, the suit pocket, all through down to where I will join the lining with the bodies. So I want to make the suit foam pocket, which is the double leaves. So the size of the pocket I use is 5 1/4. So I sew 1/4 at one side, and I sew 1/4 at the other side. So I turn the pocket, I turn it in, so I will sew 1/2 inch at that part. Then I turn the second one in, then I sew 1/2 inch at the down part as well. So then I sew the side of the pocket. So I mark 8 1/4 there. Then I mark 1 1/2 before drawing the line for the pocket. So I sew 4 inches for adult pocket. Then the upper one I don't put stay, so I sew it from 1/2 inch before that one. So I sew 3 inch for that, then I notch it. I notch it at the side. Turn the upper part of the pocket inside and then open it with iron, and also fold the down part of the pocket, the one they stay, by 1 inch. You fold it by 1 inch. So you fold it by 1 inch. Then you notch so that you can turn it inside, so the notch will get to where you are sewing get to. So be at that point where your sewing get to, so that it can go inside. Then you sew these two that I'm holding together, you sew them together, join that two that I'm holding, join them together. So after you join them together, you can see what the lines of the sewing. So after you join them together, you fold the pockets to the shape of the to form a suit pocket shape. So at that part is not. This part is not straight, a beast lands just by quarter. A beast lands inside while the other side is straight. The other side close to the armor is straight. The other side close to the armor is straight. When you mark where the pockets will get to, where your sewing will get to, so use your hand to hold it from inside, then sew. So your sewing will be at that line where you mark with chalk. So you do the same thing to the other side. Just use your hand to hold it from inside, and make sure it doesn't move. Then you sew. Your sewing is like, it's just 1 inch. Your sewing is just 1 inch down. After you've sewn it, you just try to, you sew the pocket so that hand cannot enter. It's not a tight sewing, just a loose stitch. Then you sew the pocket around the inside. To cut every excess inside. So iron it from inside. Use an Airstay to hold it. So you fold the lapel part, so your folding will get to where that pocket is. Just to give us the shape, let's have the shape of the lapel, let's see how the lapel look like. So your folding is, then you make the suit cover pocket. So you measure the length before making the cover pocket. So any length it give you, you add quarter to it. You add quarter to the length while making your suit cover. So I've had quarter to the length it gives me. I've had quarter to it. That's why I'm sewing 5.5. The size of the pocket is 5.25, so I'm sewing 5.5. So you use your lining to turn it in. After which you put SD on the, on what you are using for the cover. Then you turn it inside. Use your needle and thread. Use your needle and thread to brace it so that the lining does not show outside but inside. You use your hand to make sure the lining is inside. So after brazing it, you put it inside the weld pocket you have made. Then you measure the length of the cover pocket you want. So the length I use is 2.5 from the line of the pocket. So you can use 2.25 or 2.5. Then you sew it, you stitch it at the upper part. Then you use lining to cover it inside. So you sew the upper part. Then you sew the down part of the pocket as well. Then you join the side. So you join the side of the pocket of the lining you use to cover it inside. So that is the pocket. Then you measure the width of your warding from the gator to the joining of the side front. So that is the what you use to cut your warding out. So the measurement I got from that part is 9.25. So you cut your welding. Mostly adults is around 9.5. So you can, even if you not measure it from 9.5 above to 10 inches, depending on the chest of the person, but take the measurement so that you'll be sure of it. So after you've done that, you place the welding on top of the canvas. So that is the canvas. So you place it on top of the canvas. The warding has a gum on it. So once you place it on the canvas, it will gum on it. You place it on the canvas, then it gum on it. So the warding you use is a thick warding. So if you use a light warding, you can double it. But you use a thick warding. So then you turn it to the other side. Make sure You leave half inch at the tip of the canvas, and that half inch will be at the two side. So at that two side facing each other, the half inch will be there. Yeah, you can see. Then you place your iron on top of it to gum it. Although it takes time before it gum, depending on the kind of warden you buy, it takes time before it gum. So after you have gum it, you place it on top of your suit. So it will be half inch above your suit downward. So the length I use for the cutting of the warden is I use 14.5 for the length. So you place this stay on that part so that it will hold it to the suit. So you apply water and gum it together. So make sure your canva is more than the warden at the upper and the up and the down of the length. So after you gum it together, you use iron to gum it together as to how it stay. So this is how it will look like. So you can use scissors to cut the excess at that part. Then you use your needle and thread. You use it to hold both the fabrics and the warding together. So you use it to brace it, just to hold it together. So after you have done that, you place it on the iron, you place it on the machine, then you sew. Your sewing is starting from 1 inch before. So when you are cutting, you leave space. You leave like quarter before cutting it out. You leave quarter at the starting. You leave quarter at the starting when you are cutting it. Then you don't sew from you leave 1 inch so that when you are joining the shoulder, that will be for the shoulder, so you be able to join your shoulder. Then you cut the excesses out. Your sewing will stop at where your front panel is joined with the side front. So the cutting of the line is suit lining. So you measure after you have placed the lining, you fold the lining into two, then place the back suit back on it, then fold the back into two. Then at that every side you measure 1 inch all around. Measure 1 inch all around. Then you cut it out. So you cut the back lining out. So then you place the facing on the lining. So you mark that part. So after marking it, you place the front panel, which you have joined with the side front, on it. Then you leave 1 inch. You add 1 inch to the side as well, the side of the front. You add 1 inch to it. Another vent part, you add 3/4, half inch or 3/4. So while cutting it, you cut the half inch. So that half inch is for the joining. So for the sleeve, you cut the exact shape of the major sleeve, the exact shape. After you might have folded it, then while cutting the under sleeve, you leave 1 inch above. So let's join the suit lining with the suit back lining with the clothes. So after you might have joined the so you sew that part. Make sure it's at the exact place of where the cloth is as well. So after you might have sewn it, you also join the facing with the lining. Join the facing with the lining. So while joining the facing with the lining, you join from down part to the upper part by 1/2 inch. Your sewing will be 1/2 inch. Can see what I meant by so the joining of the suit back and the lining, they will be the same. So you want to cut the excess lining at the suit back. Other slit of the suit back. So it's the point of where your vent gets to, that is where I'm cutting. So you did the same thing to the other side as well. So you iron the part of the facing that you have sewn as well. So iron the facing so that it will be smooth. Now you've done that, you apply a stay inside it. So at that, you mark 15 inches from the upper part of the suit, then you apply a stay. So this is inside of the suit, you apply a stay inside the suit. Yes, it can be 14 inches length and breadth of 5 inches. So you mark 4 inches for the suit pocket. So the essence of putting a stay inside is so that that part where you are going to sew, there will be a stay inside. So I'm sewing the suit back, the vent part, the side of the vent. I'm sewing it with the lining. So you iron the back of the suit. Then you also make pockets. So you sew quarter and quarter on both sides. So the size of the pocket that will be inside the facing is 4 inches. Then you stick it to the machine to stitch it. So you notch the side of the pocket, then you stitch it inside. Then you iron the pockets. This is just a single wet pocket inside the suit. Then you apply SD and aiming gun on the suit facing. Just at the position where you join the facing and the lining. So apply SD and aiming gun. So when you sew it, the gumming part must face up so that it can gum with the front panel. So ensure that when you are sewing it, it does not get to where you have sewn before. So this is what I've sewn. You can see the position. So if there's no pocket, it will be straight down. So after you have applied ST and ME gum, you sew both the facing and the front panel. You sew the two together. You join the two together. So you start from the peak part of the lapel. Then you sew it downward. Alright, so you sew the facing with the front panel. Ensure that they are equal. And make sure that is the front panel that is on top when you are stitching it. So the facing will be under when you are stitching it. So you stitch it round. At the edge, you bend it a bit. You bend it towards the front panel. You can see that place I hold it. You bend that place. So you stitch it all down to your vent area. Stitch everything. So after you stitch that place, you notch that ghetto area, then you push every excess lining to inside. Then you stitch it. Then you turn it inside. So you apply stay on this part of the pointed part. Then you turn the front part inside. Then you begin by brazing it. You braze it around all where you sew, all where you join together, you braze it around. So at that facing that would show as a lapel, you ensure that you turn it inside while brazing it. So at the lapel side, you turn it inside. So where I'm brazing, you make sure it's inside. So you braze it round. Ensure that where not part that we should at the outside the suit, ensure that that part does not, ensure you turn it inside. Other space that will show outside. So you can see it. So turn it in so you can see that part will be inside. So it's the gator that separates the lapel and the other side that will overlap on each other. So once you get to that gator part, it will be a reverse case since you are turning it in before. So you'll be turning it inside again. I'll show you. Once you get to that gator, it's in before, so it will be, it's outside before, so it will come inside now. so you can see the outside. So once you get to that gate door, you will be turning it inside with the needle. Okay, do you see? It's not showing outside. So can you see? It's not show outside. So you raise it, you get to the down part. So you can see it on that the lapel area to go inside. Can you see it? That is the vent area. I mean the overlap. You brace the down part as well. When you are bracing it, make sure the lining does not show outside. Show that the lining does not show outside, so you turn it in.
So after braising it, you take it to the table so you can iron it. So you can add water so that the ST and the enemy gun you put in on the facing can gum with the front panel. So you iron from the down part. So you iron the down part. So when you iron one part before moving to the other part. So from down you iron to the upper part. So the major impact here is the area you apply ST and the enemy gun. So you put a cloth on it so that the iron will not stay in the front, the lapel part, because that part will show on the front of your suit. So you put a cloth or a facing that you can use to iron. So you make sure there is no folding when ironing it, when you are ironing the inside. So you use the iron to get the shape of the lapel. So you are on the outside as well. You iron the lapel part as well. So after you are done, you do the same thing to the other part of the front.
So you ensure you iron it thoroughly, because this is where your work will tell. So this is like a finishing part of a finishing work. So you raise the other part. So you can see it. So that is the lapel part. Can see how I praise it. So the second hand that is not with the needle is the one controlling. It's the one controlling it. The position of where you are going to brace. So this is the second part. So I've ironed the inside. So this is the outside.
So you trim the excess lining. So you leave 3/4. So iron the back panel. Especially the joining part of the middle. Trim the excess lining. So you place the front panel on top of the back panel. So you use an office pin to hold the front panel around the vent part with the back panel.
So we want to sew the vent area. So before you can sew it, you use an office pin to hold it before sewing it. So you can see I've held that part with office pin. So you take it down to the machine in order to stitch the vent area. So you can see how I've used the an office pin to hold it. The office pin will show on both sides, inside and outside. So you use it to hold the front panel and the back panel. So around that vent part, you use office pin to hold it. Then you stitch the vent area to your armhole part. So we are joining the side of the suit, but this is a double vent, so you have to stitch the vent area. So this is where we want to stitch. You stitch it up to where you have your gator of the vent, then you stitch it upward. So just like half inch before the lining, you stitch it down to the gator area, then you stitch it up to your where you have your armhole. So the first thing is stitch the vent area. So that is where I want to stitch now. You first stitch the fabrics with the fabrics, then you stitch the lining separately. So what control your stitching is the gator area, the gator part. make sure when you are stitching it, you don't stitch the lining with it. So once you get to the gaiter part, you stop, then you stitch it upward. So it's the gaiter at the back panel that will control your stitches. So you can see, so I've stitched that part. And I'll stitch it upward also. You can see it. So after you have stitched it, you can see my stitches. So once you are done with that, you notch the front part, then you open where you have stitched. So at this part, so you notch the front up to the gaiter part where you sew. Where you have your V, so you notch it up to that part. Then you open it. So you open that part where you join your front panel and your back panel together. Where you join it, you open it. so you can see what you have. So you, after that, you join the lining, the front panel lining and the back panel lining. So from that vent, you join the lining together. So you're saying we start from where you start joining your the fabrics, the front panel and the back panel. So where you started before, that is where you're saying you start from also. So immediately you pass where you join the lining and the front panel back panel together, you start joining it upward. So this part, when you are joining it, you try to bend your lining to that side. So you sew it so it will meet up with what you're having here at the back panel. So this is the result of what I joined now. So you do the same thing also to the other side of the vent. and see the result of what I joined. So you do the same thing to the other side as well. So you do the same thing to the other side of the vent. Then you sew it. So where I hold, if it's not, that part is not equal. You can trim it to be equal. So that part where you are going to start your sewing from, if it's not equal, you can trim it to be equal. So this part I'm sewing, if they are not equal, you can trim it to be equal, so that you have a good result. So, if this part is not equal, trim them to be equal. So your sewing will stop at where you have your ghetto line of the back vent. Then you stitch it upward. So you follow the ghetto when you are sewing it. So this is the result of the vent. So it's time to join the shoulder. So you join the shoulder together. So your journey will start from the arm up side of the shoulder. So you join it by 1/2 inch. So you use 1/2 inch to join it, the shoulder. Join the shoulder. After joining the shoulder, you join the lining at the shoulder also. So your joining will start from the arm up part while joining the shoulder. You start your joining from the arm up part of the shoulder to your neck area. So you join it by 1/2 inch. You also join the lining as well. So after you have joined it, you open it from inside. So you can see how I open it. So you can see I've joined the line here also. You can see it on me. It's not my measurement anyway. It's not my measurements. So I measure the arm around what it gives me. So the roundness of the armor is 21.5 inches. So that means the sleeve will be 24.5, which is our sleeve also. So you sew that part with the warding. You stitch the remaining part with the warding. So you can see it.